Father, I thank you for your word that is a lamp unto our feet and light unto our pathway. I thank you that you have blessed us with every good and perfect gift that comes down from the Father of lights, with which there is no shadow of turning. I thank you today that you are a faithful God. And because you've loved us so much, you brought us to this place. I'm going to ask right now, with your heads bowed and your eyes closed, and no one looking around. I'm not going to call you forward today, but I'll pray for you right where you're at. If you're here today and you say, Pastor, I want you to pray for me because I'm not even sure that I'm saved today, but I want to know that Jesus is the Lord of my life before I leave this place. If that's you, just raise your hand and put it back down. I'll pray for you before you leave. Anyone in this place, thank you. Anyone else? I want to know for sure that I'm saved before I leave. It's a simple prayer. Won't hurt anybody in this place, anybody else, before we pray. Guys, would you pray this prayer with that one person that raised their hand? It will never hurt you to pray this prayer. Simple prayer just says, Dear Jesus, ask me into my heart. I confess with my mouth that Jesus is Lord. I believe in my heart that God raised Jesus from the dead. Right now, because of my confession, I'm saved. Thank you, Lord, for saving my soul. Now I'm going to ask one more thing. Your heads bowed and your eyes closed. If you're hearing me say, Pastor, I'm saved, but I've let some things in life try to drown my praise out. I've let some things in life try to hold me back and some circumstances that try to pull me down. But I want prayer today, and I want to make a commitment that things are changing as of today, and I'm going to serve God with all that I have. If that's you, would you just raise your hand and put it back down? Thank you for hands all over the building. Father, I thank you that your people love you so much that they want to serve you. And I ask right now that you would just give them the encouragement that they need to be able to take that step of faith to say, Lord, I'm going to serve you regardless of the circumstance, regardless of what's going on in my life, regardless of the consequence, I'm going to serve you. And Father, I'm going to praise you today. Father, I ask that you would just instill in your people a spirit of praise instead of that weight and that heaviness and the anxiety and the depression. I just bind all those things that are trying to hurt your people. And Father, I lose the blessings and the anointing and the peace of God into their life. Father, that they would walk in the wisdom and they would walk in the peace that you call them to walk in. And Father, I speak right now a new determination over your people that they're going to march on through and they're going to praise you in the midst of all their stuff. And Father, I thank you that right now you're making a way when it doesn't seem to be a way in their life. You're strengthening them. I speak healing power right now in the name of Jesus from the top of their head to the soles of their feet. I speak the peace of God that passes all their understanding, Father, that right now in the midst of all the anger and all the shame and all the doubt and the fear and the anxiety that's trying to come upon them, Father, I break it right now in the name of Jesus. By the authority of Jesus Christ, I break every stronghold that's trying to hold them down. And Father, I lose a spirit of encouragement, a spirit of worship, a spirit of praise, a spirit of a new determination, Father, that they're just going to keep walking on through this. And Father, I thank you that you are lifting them out in and out. Father, I thank you that because you began a good work in them, you will be faithful to complete it. Yes. I speak right now that this word that has been spoken over them, that it will not return void, but it will accomplish and achieve the purpose for which it stands. I speak right now over your people that as they leave this place, they walk in a new peace and a new freedom. Knowing that you are guiding them, that you are lifting them up. And Father, that right now, in this very moment, you are making all things new. All things new. I want you to hear that. All things new. Quit worrying about yesterday. Quit worrying about last. last year. Quit worrying about what somebody else said. Quit worrying about your future. Just know that God has it all in control. Relax and enjoy the ride and know that God is going. God, oh, somebody, you need to hear this. God is bringing somebody into your life. You've been praying and praying and praying and watching and watching. Is that it? Is that it? Is that it? God is bringing somebody that is divinely appointed and anointed that will be of encouragement to you, that will help you get to the next level rather than bringing you down to their level. And God, ooh, and God is telling you today that you just need to be encouraged. Watch, your best is still on its way. Your best is still yet to come. You can still rejoice. You can still enjoy your life. I am here to tell you that that disease is not going to kill you. That worry is going to leave your mind because the peace of God is coming in. And right now, you're not. I just speak right now that worry that's trying to make you worry about what everybody else is going to say or what somebody's going to do or what's this going to do. If I take this step, what's it going to do? Oh. Develop an Abraham spirit in you and begin to step out by faith. Even when you don't understand it, you just keep walking. You just keep stepping. And you just say, you know what? I know, God, you wouldn't bring me through this if you weren't going to help me do this. And Father, if you are making a way right now, somebody, you've been trying to figure out how you're going to do this. God said, you don't have to figure it out anymore. Quit trying to figure it out. Quit trying to make it. Quit trying to do all these other things. God is going to do it for you. And whenever he does it, you won't have to worry anymore. You're just going to relax. I want to give you a word of instruction. If there are things that are weighing you down, if there are things that are making your life so complicated, then figure out a way. Come talk to me, come talk to Pastor Shetty, come talk to one of the leaders and say, I need to figure out a way to lighten my load so that I can do what God called me to do. There's nothing more important than serving God. Nothing more important than that. All the rest is just stuff and fluff. You don't have to have all that other stuff, but you have to have Jesus. You have to have his anointing in your life. You need his guidance and his direction. You need his comfort and his care. You need his direction today. And I promise you, God is not going to reject you. He's not going to turn you down. But I promise, he will lead you out. Get you to that place where you can just say, oh, again, if it had not been for the Lord on my side, I wouldn't even be here. I wouldn't be able to walk. I wouldn't be able to cope with life. I wouldn't be able to figure out how I was going to get through this. But I want you to know that today, God is making. I want to tell you something. I just got to give you some of these words this morning. Get people in your life that encourage you, not people that need you. You are not the Savior. You're not the Holy Ghost. Yes, we're called to help. We're called to mourn with those who mourn, to weep with those who weep, rejoice with those who rejoice. But I'm going to tell you, if your whole life is spent trying to fix other people, you'll never be able to enjoy who God calls you to be. Maybe you just need to get to that place in your life where you just say, you know what, I'm going to do everything I can to help you, but I'm not going to allow you to get me to this place of discouragement. Because some of you have tried to help people so much that it's brought you to a place of discouragement and got you to a place where you didn't even know how you could handle your own life. Back up and begin to look at what God has placed in your life. Figure out what God has put there and what God didn't. Rejoice in the things that God put there and what God didn't put there. Get rid of. And just enjoy the presence of God. I want you to understand, God wants you to enjoy your life, not just get through. Not just get through, not just, oh, if I can just face tomorrow, if I can just do. You know what? You need to relax and know that God has everything under control. I want to tell you this morning, God has everything under control. It may not look like it. It may not always feel like it. I think whenever I get to heaven, David is going, the psalmist David is going to say, did you need to quote me so much? But this has been my theme song for the last 5 years. I was young, and now I'm old. And never have I seen the righteous forsaken, or his seed